Okay friends, welcome to next class is the drugs for the hyperlipidemia, dyslipidemia. These are the commonly lipids, cholesterol, triglycerides and phospholipids. And these are the major source of the atherosclerosis. And the atherosclerosis, you see the 90% of the disease patients are suffering from the atherosclerosis. You see the typical structure of the lipoproteins. It is the apolipoproteins. Free cholesterol is there, the phospholipid, and core is the triglyceride and the cholesterol status. When you see the normal metabolism of the lipoproteins, these are the bile. Bile is also cholesterol, which get released into the GIT, and by the intrahepatic circulation, it enter into the liver and further responsible for the synthesis and turnover of the other cholesterols, and this liver directly releases the bile into the GIT. And whatever the dietary cholesterol is there, which get after the digestion, which get converted into the chylomicron. This chylomicron get absorbed through the lymph, and in the systemic circulation is the lipoprotein lipase. It degrade this triglyceride into cholesterol ester, and what is the remaining thing is the chylomicron remnant, which is the major source for the liver. It is get transported into liver by the LDL receptor. And whatever the cholesterol synthesized by the liver, triglycerides are the cholesterol, get these cholesterol, either triglyceride or cholesterol ester, or from that get reabsorbed by the intrahepatic circulation in the form of the bile. All these three form, it produces the VLDL. VLDL is the type of the lipids, cholesterols, which is continuously secreted by the liver. And when this VLDL comes in the systemic circulation, it further metabolized by the lipoprotein lipase and get converted in the IDL. And this IDL, it is get transported into the liver by this LDL receptor, or it get further converted into LDL, and which act on the peripheral tissue. And act on the peripheral tissue at the store, or may produce some adverse effect. And it is the HDL, which act as a peripheral transport of the cholesterol to the liver. This is the whole story of the lipoprotein metabolism. And we are discussing about the individual lipoproteins. First is the chylomicron. It is the dietary source of cholesterol. These are the apoproteins, and the synthesis is the intestine. And mechanism of the metabolism is the triglyceride hydrolysis by the lipoprotein lipase, and function the transport of the triglycerides from the intestine to the liver. And the VLDL, it is produced by the liver, and and these are the apoproteins synthesis into the liver, and triglyceride hydrolysis by the lipoprotein lipase, and transport the triglyceride from liver to the adipose tissue or the muscles. And this is the IDL. These are the cholesterol ester, these are the lipoprotein product of the after the degradation of the VLDL, and 50% converted to the LDL, and 50% get uptake by the liver. And it is the intermediate between the VLDL and LDL. And LDL is the cholesterol ester. Major lipoprotein is apolipoprotein B100, and product from the ILDL. And these are the apolipoprotein 100 mediated uptake by the LDL receptor in the liver, transport the cholesterol to peripheral tissue. And the HDL is very beneficial. HDL, the phospholipid cholesterol ester. These are the apolipoprotein A, B, C, E, and D, and the source is the intestine, liver, and plasma. Complex transfer of the cholesterol ester to the VLDL and LDL. Uptake of LDL cholesterol by the hepatocyte. Absorb cholesterol from the peripheral tissue and transport it into the liver. This is reservoir for the exchange of the lipoprotein in VLDL and chylomicron. These are lipoproteins. You see the type of the dyslipidemia. Secondary, not clear cut reason. It may be the diabetes mellitus, nephrotic syndrome, hyperthyroidism, smoking, drug, or lack of the physical activity. And primary, it may be monogenic or the polygenic. Monogenic means involvement of the one gene or other genes. Potential drug target for the dyslipidemia. Here, cholesterol gets synthesized by the acetyl coenzyme A, and this is the HMG coenzyme A reductase that is involved in the conversion of the HMG coenzyme to the mevalonate. The rate limiting step process, slowest step, and the drug like the statin, simvastatin, lovastatin, acetylcholinesterase, these inhibit this the conversion of HMG coenzyme A to the mevalonate, and therefore inhibit the synthesis of the cholesterol. When the cholesterol synthesis in the liver get decreases, formation of and release of the VLDL from liver to the systemic circulation get decreases. And second drug is the fibrate. It upregulate the LPL receptor. Other drug is the niacin, which inhibit the lipolysis of the lipolysis of the adipose tissue and decreases the circulating level of the free fatty acid. And these are the drug like the cholesterol, inhibit the cholesterol absorption from the GIT, like the ezetimibe. This ezetimibe inhibit the absorption of the cholesterol from intestine to the blood. And bile acid sequestrant, aldrazine, it sequestered positive charge compound, sequester the bile acid and prevent it further reabsorption, and ultimately inhibit the lipid layer of the cholesterol. And these are the drugs, these PCSK9, which degrade the LDL receptor. When you give the antibody PCSK9, upregulate the LDL receptor, and therefore increase the uptake of the cholesterol from the plasma to the liver. When you are discussing about the drug, major drug is the HMG coenzyme A reductase inhibitor that are more commonly used drug, that is the atorvastatin, rosuvastatin, pitavastatin, simvastatin and lovastatin. Bile acid sequestrant, that is the cholestyramine, cholestipol, and so on and so forth. And cholesterol absorption inhibitor, ezetimibe. Fibrate, fenofibrate, gemfibrozil, and nicotine, acid, nicotinic acid, niacin is a vitamin. And PCSK9 inhibitor, that is the antibody, eralicumab and evolucumab. And apoprotein B synthesis inhibitor, that is the mepomersen. And the MTP inhibitor is the lumitapide, and other drug are the CEPT inhibitor and the APOC3 inhibitors and glucagon and omega-3 fatty acids. When I'm discussing about the statin inhibit the HMG coenzyme reductase. When it inhibit the HMG coenzyme reductase here, that is the enzyme responsible for the synthesis of the cholesterol, and the cholesterol synthesis get inhibited. When cholesterol synthesis get inhibited, and other way the feedback upregulation of the LDL receptor is there, and therefore second step is the upregulation of the LDL receptor on the hepatocytes. First things, it inhibit the cholesterol synthesis statin by inhibiting this enzyme HMG coenzyme reductase inhibitor. Second things, when the plasma cholesterol level get decreased, there is a feedback upregulation of the LDL receptor on the hepatocyte. You can say it stimulates the LDL receptor synthesis and upregulation of the LDL receptor. When the LDL receptor is there, you can say LDL receptor mediated, you see, LDL receptor mediated this cholesterol transport get increases, and therefore plasma cholesterol level get decreases. And this fourth thing is the you see the low intracellular cholesterol decreases the secretion of VLDL. Ultimately, when the cholesterol synthesis get inhibited by the liver, secretion of the cholesterol in the form of the VLDL get decreases. Therefore, you see statin inhibit the plasma cholesterol level, either four way. First, inhibits the HMG coenzyme reductase inhibitor, synthesis of cholesterol. Second thing is it upregulates the LDL receptor. And third thing is promote the LDL receptor mediated degradation, or you can say metabolism of the LDL. Fourth thing, it decreases the, when the cholesterol synthesis of the hepatocyte get decreases, it further decreases the its transport, its secretion from liver to systemic circulation. It strengthens first pass metabolism, and simvastatin, lovastatin are the prodrug. T half is 1 to 4 hour. Atorvastatin is the T half is the 20 hours. Simvastatin is the 12 hours. A major adverse effect is the gastrointestinal disturbance, skeletal muscles, and hepatic. In the GI symptom, that is the adverse effect is the indigestion, heartburn, nausea, abdominal pain, and skeletal muscle, that the myalgia and myopathy, meiosis, and myoglobinuria, and hepatic, that the hepatic toxicity, that is very serious toxicity and common toxicity. Drug interaction fibrate, especially gemfibrozil, is the having good drug interaction and causing the one of the major cause of the hepatotoxicity. Enzymes, that is the inhibitors, like as the CYP34A, may increase the toxicity of the statin, and fluvastatin and pravastatin having the less risk. And niacin enhance the inhibition of the skeletal muscles cholesterol synthesis. Contraindication in the very much contraindication in the case of the never should give in the statin and the pregnancy and lactation. And the drug of choice for the hypercholesterolemia. Other is the bile acid sequestrant. These are the positive, highly positive charged compound which bind to the negatively charged binding to the GIT and forming a complex. When it forming a complex, it inhibits the further intrahepatic circulation of the bile. Bile is the form of the cholesterol, and ultimately it gets processed out through the fecal matter. And when the cholesterol get decreases from the systemic circulation, the intrahepatic cholesterol pool get also decreases it, and that feedback upregulation of the HMG coenzyme is there, and therefore VLDL synthesis is increased and secretion get increased, and therefore further it produces more bile, and that gets sequestered and get pass out from the fecal matter, and LDL receptor get expression get increased, and therefore LDL mediated VLDL and IDL clearance is there, and ultimately plasma level above the LDL and LDL level other lipid get also decreased. So friend, the major mechanism of action of this bile acid sequestrant is the highly positive charge compound. Bile is the negatively charged compound, make a complex, inhibit its further intrahepatic circulation and reabsorption, and ultimately cholesterol level get decreased. Heartburn, dyspepsia, bloating, gritty sensation is the major adverse effect, and also decrease the absorption of the folic acid and vitamin K, and constipation may be adverse effect. And it binds to digoxin, warfarin, and further inhibits its absorption. So the drugs like the warfarin, thyroxine, and furosemide, thiazides are given. It should be, there should be gap between 1 to 3 hours. That is the contraindicated in hypertriglyceridemia, therapeutic use in the heterozygous family of hypercholesterolemia, and drug of choice for the children and a female in the reproductive age. Cholesterol acid, cholesterol absorption inhibitor. Here the drug ezetimibe, which inhibit the drug, which inhibit the absorption of the cholesterol from GI to the systemic circulation. When the cholesterol absorption from GIT get decreases, it further reduces the cholesterol transport to the liver, And when the absorption get inhibited, cholesterol transported to the liver of this chylomicron or this lipid get decreased. And when the cholesterol level of this plasma get decreases, the upregulation of the LDL receptor is there by feedback induction. When the LDL receptor get upregulated, four things, the LDL mediated further cholesterol transport is there, and ultimately the plasma LDL receptor get decreased. Drug like as the ezetimibe, very good drug, 10 mg tablets, bile acid sequestrant inhibits absorption, so should be not co-administered with the bile acid sequestrant with the ezetimibe drug. And something is having the allergic reaction. Fibrate, it is activator of the PPAR alpha gene transcription regulator, increase the lipoprotein lipase activity, which leads to the degradation of triglyceride rich VLDL and inhibit the coagulation and increase the fibrillation. Abdominal discomfort, nausea, diarrhea, increase the risk of the gallstone, prolonged prothrombin time, myopathy, and high risk when it combined with the statin, especially gemfibrozil. Fenofibrate is safer. Contraindicated in the children, pregnant women, renal failure, drug of choice for the type 3 familial dysbeta lipoproteinemia, severe dysbeta lipoproteinemia means that when the triglyceride and cholesterol are equally increased, severe hyperglyceridemia and other type of the hypercholesterolemia, primary hypercholesterolemia type 2A. Niacin is a very good drug in the vitamins. It inhibits the lipolysis of the triglyceride, especially in the adipose tissue, and increase the lipoprotein lipase activity by the endothelium, increase the clearance of the chylomicron, and inhibit the rate limiting enzyme for the triglyceride synthesis in the liver, and that is the diacetylglyceridyl transferase 2. And ultimately, when the cholesterol synthesis get inhibited in the liver, decrease the triglyceride concentration and decrease the VLDL secretion, increase the lipoprotein lipase. It means the peripheral activity of the lipoprotein lipase get increases, VLDL level get decreased, and ultimately it inhibit the plasma level of the fatty acid, and also inhibit the lipolysis of adipose tissue. Side effect, these are the side effects: flushing, dyspepsia, skin distress, liver dysfunction, hyperglycemia, hyperuricemia. Risk of the myopathy is there when combined with the statin, contraindicated in peptic ulcer, gout, diabetes mellitus, and pregnancy. And the drug of therapeutic use in the hypertriglyceridemia and high LDL cholesterol associated with the low HDL, drug of choice with the familial combined hypertriglyceridemia. And also drug of choice for the dysbeta lipoproteinemia and severe mixed hypertriglyceridemia type 4. PCSK9 inhibitor. PCSK9, it is a, you see, this PCSK9, when it bind to the LDL, normal LDL receptor, it further leads to the degradation of the LDL receptor. And when the LDL receptor on the hepatocyte get decreased, it further prevent the LDL mediated metabolism of the cholesterol. LDL receptor mediated transport of the cholesterol from systemic circulation to the hepatocyte. When you give the PCSK9 inhibitor like this drug, and it monoclonal antibody, when it bind to the PCSK9, it make a complex, and this therefore PCSK9 is unable to interact with the LDL receptor and further degrade the LDL receptor, and therefore you can say when you give this type of the inhibitor, the degradation of the LDL receptor is not there, and you can say LDL receptor get upregulated. When the LDL receptor get upregulated, that is the LDL mediated cholesterol transport from the plasma to the hepatocyte get increased, and therefore LDL concentration get decreases. And LDL concentration decreases near about 50 to 70%, and lower PCSK9 activity up to the 80% of this PCSK. And this alirukumab 75 mg subcutaneously is effective up to 2 weeks, otherwise it may be increased after dose of 150 mg. And the other drug is the evokumab, which may be given up to the 140 mg. It is may be effective up to the 2 weeks, and these are the adverse effect: risk of the infection, nasopharyngitis, UTI, and especially at the site of the infection, at the site of injection, myalgia, and therapeutic use is the homozygous, heterozygous, familial hypercholesterolemia. Other is the ApoB synthesis inhibitor. When you give the ApoB synthetic inhibitor, especially the antisense oligonucleotide, these are the ApoB mRNA, which get formation of the synthesis of this type of the VLDL and especially LDL. When you give the antisense, it bind to the mRNA and further it inhibit the transcription and the formation of the VLDL. It drug is the mupomersen. Recommended as a dose of 200 mg per ml subcutaneous once a week, and metabolized in the tissue by the endonuclease oligonucleotide, which is further metabolized by the exonuclease. T-half is the 1 to 2 month. Adverse effect: the severe injection site reaction, flu-like reactions, headache, hepatotoxicity, and should not be used in the liver impairment. Therapeutic use: it is the drug used, FDA approved drug for the homozygous familial hypercholesterolemia. And due to the hepatotoxicity, it is not now commonly used drug. MTP inhibitor: this is the MTP which incorporated to the VLDL. And this is the MTP that produced by the DNA from the RNA into lipids, where it incorporated the apoprotein B and the lipids and forming the MPTP, and the faulty MPTP get incorporated to VLDL. When you give the like drug, this MPTP inhibitor, this drug is the drug combined with the MPTP and inhibit the MPTP, and therefore further further production of the VLDL get increases, and therefore ultimately VLDL level get decreased, and LDL systemic VLDL level when get decreased, LDL receptor get upregulated, and therefore LDL receptor mediated transport of the LDL from the systemic circulation to the liver get increased, and ultimately VLDL and LDL concentration get decreased. Useful in the homozygous familial hypercholesterolemia, how the lack of the LDL receptor reduce the LDL cholesterol up to the 50%. These are the adverse effect, and also causes hepatotoxicity, abdominal pain. And approved for the treatment of the homozygous familial hypercholesterolemia with restriction to the continuous monitoring. These are contraindicated, enzyme inhibitor, and the pregnancy. Other drugs: CEPT inhibitor, and these drugs ultimately, that is the CEPTP, that is responsible for the exchange of the cholesterol ester from triglyceride to the HDL, and ultimately enhance the LDL level. And this CEPTP inhibitor, as the experimental, it has been proved that it increased the HDL level, but it is not in the clinically all the drug get failed. Omega 3 fatty acid that contain the PUFA, and especially EPA and DHA, and it increases the triglyceride metabolism, and therefore decrease the plasma lipid level, and also act as the antioxidant. And dose is 4 grams per day, and that is a very good drug, and that is the CDRI Center Drug Research Institute Lucknow approved drug, that is the glucagon, and it inhibits the cholesterol biosynthesis and enhances the rate of the excretion of the cholesterol, and dose is 25 mbTDS only. And adverse effect is the some people it produces the loses to didelax symptom. So friend, we have discussed about the drug used for the hyperlipidemia. If you have any queries, please don't hesitate to write a mail. That is the hnyadav@gmail.com. Thank you very much.